Hey everyone, thanks for tuning into Test Tube Plus today. I'm Trace. This is episode 1 of 5 in our series on health and fitness. But before we get into that, I have something I'm super excited to tell you about. It's called D-News After Dark. Maybe you've watched D-News before on YouTube. It is my other science show. It's super cool. It's every single day of the week, a lot shorter, like the little brother of Test Tube Plus, even though it's way bigger. But you can come see us live on stage, some of my favorite friends from the D-News show, people who are going to talk about the far side of the moon, about scientific illusions, about bioluminescence and how the brain works, all sorts of really awesome science. Only this one night, October 22nd, at San Francisco's Castro Theater. You can buy tickets down in the description. They're going fast, so make sure you grab yours, and I hope to see you there. Okay, so back to health and fitness. We're going to talk this week about a whole bunch of different things related to fitness and how it affects your body and how your body kind of affects how you're going to do your fitness. Why do some people go to the gym when other people just stay at home? Is there an upper limit to human athletic ability? And everything in between. It's going to be a super cool series. Make sure you subscribe and keep coming back for all of the episodes this week. But first, why is it that some people go to the gym? How do they motivate themselves to get off the couch? For a lot of people, there's a mental block about getting themselves into the gym. So to really understand why some people do that and some people don't, we have to understand that mental block. I have a background in psychology. That was my undergrad. And so a lot of my background comes through behavioral psychology, or how to change behavior. So in that, we're trying to get people off the couch. We're trying to change their behavior. So let's explore this a little bit. First, we've got self-determination theory. A human behavior, any behavior, is motivated by 3 primary psychological needs: autonomy, competence, and relatedness with others. So the idea that you're able to do something is very important, as is a social event of that, and that you can do it by yourself. At different levels of physical activity, any or all 3 of these psychological needs could be activated. But once someone attains a high level of competency, you get a breakthrough. It becomes an intrinsically motivated activity. So when you start going to the gym, eventually you become confident of your ability to be able to work out at the gym. Because going to the gym is pretty intimidating, first off, right? You go there, you put your gym clothes on, and everybody seems to be doing something. Everybody's got a machine that they know how it works, and you're out there trying to read the instructions, but doing it on the sly, trying to figure out what this does and if you're using this machine right and watching other people. It's very intimidating. But after a while, once you get into the habit of going and you learn about it, you start to be rewarded by yourself. An intrinsically motivated behavior is one driven by internal reward. So this can happen after something becomes routine, which doesn't take that long, only a couple of weeks. Or if you land maybe a cool move on your skateboard outside of the gym, because you're out being active, that's important, you'll feel really good about it. And potentially that shows your competency. On top of that, it also could show your relatedness with others. If you win a big football game or get a really cool dance move down in your routine, that would also show competence and relatedness with others potentially, and even autonomy, like you know how to do this and you can do it alone. There's also things like in other sports. I mean, you could probably think of some examples that you can tell us in the comments, but intrinsic motivation is an outcome of consistent self-determination. The idea that your reward inside of your own body is the strongest reward you're going to get. You feeling good about doing a thing is going to keep you wanting to do that thing. Most of us end up going to the gym through another way, and that is extrinsic motivation, or a reward. That's when you first get started, right? In psychology, we call this the token economy. If you do something right, then you get a reward. So at school, if you answer the question right, you get some points. If you answer something right in a maybe pop quiz, you end up getting recognition in front of your teachers and your students. Video games do this all the time, where they give you little points, little flashes of light, little sound effects that make you feel good. And those rewards help drive you doing more of those good things. It's basic behavioral training. Even animal training uses this same idea. Say you want a dolphin to jump out of a pool, you have to slowly train it using something the dolphin likes, like a little fish. According to a paper written by Christina Frederick and Hannah Schuster-Smith in the Journal of Sports Behavior, there are 3 levels of this self-determination we are talking about. There's external regulation, which is where the behavior is controlled or coerced. So that's this reward system. You know, you literally give a physical reward. Maybe in training with autistic children, it's usually like an M&M, just one M&M. And it's like, you did a good job, here's one M&M. And then the next task you get, another M&M. Introjected regulation, which is the individual's desire to gain social approval and avoid disapproval, that motivates your behavior. So, you know, your friends are going to the gym, your friends join a soccer team or a football team or a dance troupe, and you want to join too because you get the reinforcement from your friends then. There's also identified regulation, where the individual is motivated through interests, abilities, and the desire to achieve self-initiated goals. This is where you feel good, and so therefore, you keep doing it again. It's personal reward. You're feeling good about it. Numerous studies on the effectiveness of extrinsic, or rewards, and intrinsic, internal feelings, show that members of, say, a college crew, for example, in a study, who were in autonomous motivational states, so they weren't being rewarded, that's psych speak for they weren't being rewarded by anybody, those people performed better than crew members who were extrinsically motivated or given a reward. So someone given a medal at the end of their race isn't gonna be as motivated as someone who's racing for their own sake or for their team or for their social group. They're motivating each other and they're motivating themselves. They're gonna probably win, much more so than the person who's just doing it for the cash prize. These two types of motivations, extrinsic or reward motivation and intrinsic or self-motivation, are kind of battling back and forth when it comes to us getting our asses off the couch and going to the gym. Originally, and in the beginning, extrinsic motivation is probably going to be the best. You know, you want to get some kind of reward to get out there and get to the gym. But over time, intrinsic motivation takes over, and you're not doing it for the reward. You're doing it because it makes you feel good to do it. According to the American College of Sports Medicine, one of the simplest intrinsic motivators is simply the knowledge that going to the gym is going to make you better. Understanding the benefits of exercise of both health of mind and also health of body will motivate people over time. It's enough in some cases to motivate people to just go to the gym because they know that it will make them healthy. A lot of people end up in that bucket. But extrinsic motivators, little rewards, don't have to be M&Ms. They don't have to be medals or cash prizes. They can also be improved physical appearance. They can be weight loss in general. You can have goal pants, you know? I want to fit into these, or I have a wedding to go to, or it's beach season. All of those things are extrinsic motivators, things that are pushing you externally to go to the gym. All of those things help. So if you have those strategies and they've worked for you in the past, keep using them. But how can we make working out easier for ourselves? Well, research suggests that about 50% of people who start an exercise program drop out in the first 6 months. And that's because a person's sense of self-perception plays a big role in whether or not they will start the exercise program in the first place. A lot of people, you know, just going to class is enough to trigger that intrinsic motivation. You feel good because you're there with other people and they're doing it and you're doing it, and that social motivation makes you feel good inside. But if not, there still is an extrinsic motivator, even though it's a small one. When you go to a class, pay for the nice class, because then you're gonna get a reward, an external reward that makes you feel like you didn't waste that money when you go to class. It sounds counterintuitive, but it works. If you spend a little extra money for your gym as opposed to getting the cheapest gym, you'll feel good about going to the gym because you'll feel like that was money well spent. And that is an extrinsic reward. You go to class, you feel good, because not only did you go to class, intrinsic, but you didn't waste money on a gym membership, extrinsic. Behaviorism is complicated, but this works. I know that it's hard to get started. It's hard to get your butt off the couch and get out there and go to the gym. The cognitive evaluation theory says that basically external factors like rewards and competition, feedback and punishment, those can decrease motivation. These factors can enhance, they can undermine the intrinsic motivational feelings you get by just going to the gym, because there's not a lot of reward in the beginning. You know, this works across different things, not just the gym. You maybe don't make your doctor appointment. I've been trying to make a dental appointment for a year, and I still haven't done it. I really should go to the dentist, you guys. But I haven't, because there's not a lot of motivation to do so. It's more discouragement. I feel discouraged over time, because now it's like, kind of embarrassing, I haven't been to the dentist in a while, now my dentist is gonna judge. That's me punishing myself. It's bad. I should go to the dentist. The more controlling the environment, it also will affect how you feel about it. So if you're going to join a sports team of a sport you've never played, the rules and the regulations of that sport will also discourage you. You'll have to jump through more hoops in order to be doing the same thing that people who already know all those rules can do. And that's considered a punishment, something else discouraging you. So, you know, new kinds of classes you've never taken before, joining sports teams, like I said, those are all kind of discouraging because of the controlling environment that you're joining. And that also adds up to less intrinsic motivation. Eventually, you're just not going to go. So many of us, we are our biggest obstacle for going to the gym. We get in our own head about it, and then we don't go to the gym because we get discouraged, and then time has passed, and then we're like, well, now I haven't gone to the gym in a year, and it's bad, and now I feel bad about it. That's called the sick social cycle. It's bad, and you're just driving it yourself. So how do you break out of it? Get off the couch and go to the gym. It sounds hard, maybe, but it's not. It's easy. Just go. And if you really want to motivate yourself, take time to learn about how fitness can help you be healthier, and then get in there and do what you know. If you knew how to run because you ran in high school, go run at the gym. Because just going there and doing the thing that you know is gonna help you keep wanting to go back. If you only know how to bike because you biked as a kid, go jump on a bike at the gym. Still, do it there because it will motivate you to keep going back and you'll get that intrinsic reward. Start where you're most comfortable and gradually you'll gain competency. You'll feel better about yourself. The intrinsic motivations will start. The goal pants will be in reach. And then you'll end up going to the gym and you'll be one of those people. It's as easy as that. The thing is though, you can go too hard. We're going to talk about that tomorrow. What happens if you do that? So make sure you subscribe and come back to Test Tube Plus so that you can figure that out for us or with us tomorrow. Thanks for watching, and we have a special guest coming in as well tomorrow, so make sure you keep tuning in. We'll see you tomorrow on Test Tube Plus.